Hello children, welcome back to the maths class of class 9th. Today we shall continue with the chapter number 4, construction of triangles. Today we shall see construction of a triangle when the base angles are given to us and the perimeter is given to us. So let's start with 4.3 practice set. First question, in triangle PQR, angle Q is 70, angle R is 80. And the perimeter of the triangle, that is PQ plus QR plus PR, is given to you as 9.5. So from the given information, we will first draw the rough figure. So in triangle PQR, so you are supposed to draw triangle PQR where angle Q is 70 degree and angle R is 80 degree. But the base side is not given to us. So the perimeter which is given to us becomes the base side. Okay. Why it becomes the base side? Because when you add AQ plus QR plus RB will give you 9.5. Okay. So that becomes the base side. So we are going to write AQ plus QR plus RB is 9.5. So the perimeter which is given becomes the base over here. Then we are going to draw the perpendicular bisectors for the sides. For the side PA and for the side PB. So first let us see, this was a rough figure. Now let us see the fair figure. Construction part will move ahead. So first you are going to draw a line segment of 9.5 cm. So you can see I am going to draw a line segment of 9.5 centimeter. This is A and B. You can name this any point whatever you wish. That is 9.5 centimeter. Next, after that, what is given to us? This angle is given to us as 70 degree, angle Q, and angle R is given 80, but we don't know from where shall we start angle Q and from where shall we start angle R. So now, we have to draw angle. So what we are going to do, we'll take, now this is angle Q is 70. So what is half of 70? 35, right? So we'll draw angle of 35 degree from point A. Okay? So from point A, we'll take half of 70. So half of 70 is 35. So this is 35 degree, right? Half of 70. And your angle R is 80. So what is half of 80? 40. So from B, I'm going to draw angle of 40 degree. So from angle B, my 40 is over here. So I'm going to draw angle of 40 degree. Okay, so this I can name as point P. Okay, this is my point P. Next, you're going to draw a perpendicular bisector for PA and PB. Okay, so let's start from point P. I take a small appropriate distance of more than half. You can see I've taken a distance more than half. Draw arc up and an arc down. Okay. Similarly, from point A, draw arc up and an arc down. But now here my arc doesn't meet. So what I will do, I will just extend my arc over here. Okay. So you could see how I've done it. So now I'm going to join these two by drawing a okay. So this is my perpendicular bisector. It divides this into two equal half. So this point, okay, I can name that as point Q. Q. Okay, this is my point Q. Okay, now next I will draw a perpendicular bisector for PB. I have taken a distance more than half. Okay, I have taken a distance more than half and I have drawn a arc up and an arc. Sorry children, it's shaking. Okay, an arc up and an arc down. Similarly, from point B, I am going to bisect that previous arc. Okay, so now this is the point of intersection. So I have drawn a perpendicular bisector for PB. Okay, so now this divides into two equal halves. So this is my point P. This is my point R. So I'm going to join PR. Okay, and I will be joining segment PQ. Okay, I hope so you all have followed this. So this, if you measure, you will get it as 70 degree, and if you measure this, you should get this as 80 degree. Okay, so when you measure this, these two should be same. Okay, so that means AQ and PQ is same, and so this is a PR and RB is same. Okay, these two are divided into two equal half by the perpendicular bisector. So this is a required figure. So if you see from point R, we can see from point R, if I place the protector, I get an angle of 80 degree. And if I place the protector at point Q, okay, if I place the protector at point Q, I get an angle of, I get an angle of 70 degree. Okay, so when you place the protector on the line or on that point, you should get the same angle, then only your figure is right. Okay, now let's see the next sum. Question number 2. In triangle XYZ, angle Y is given to us as 58 degree. And angle X is given to us as 46. So X is 46 degree and Y is 58 degree. So you can see I have drawn a rough figure. Okay. So this entire thing which is given, the perimeter is given to us as 10.5. Okay. So first what we will do, we will first draw line segment of 10.5 centimeter. So let's draw. Okay. So this is PQ of 10.5 centimeter. Then next, angle X is 46, right? So what is half of 46? 23. So from point P, okay, from point P, I will draw angle of 23 degree. So 23 is here. Okay. So I will just draw so you can see I have drawn an angle of 23 degree. Now angle Q, angle Y is 58, so half of 58 is 29. So from angle Q you will draw angle of 29 degree. Okay, So I have drawn an angle of 29 degree. Then next, this is my point Z. Now next step, same. You're going to draw a perpendicular bisector for PZ and ZQ. So first, I draw a perpendicular bisector for PZ. Take a distance more than half. Draw arc up and arc down. Similarly, from point P, bisect the previous arc. Now here it is not getting bisected. So what I do, I just extend the arc. Okay, I erase this part. Okay. So now next, I'm going to draw a straight perpendicular line. Okay, so these are divided into two equal halves. Okay, so this is my point X. Okay, next. Now we'll draw a perpendicular bisector for ZQ. Same way, place the point at point Q, take a distance more than half, draw arc up and arc down. From point Z also, draw arc here and arc here. Okay, so from this, I draw perpendicular line. So this is also 90. It divides into two equal half. Okay, so I have shown this by identical mark, right? So now this is my point Y. So join ZY and ZX. Okay, so this should be 46 degree and this should be 58 degree. So this is a required figure. And this is same, this is also same. You have to show the identical marks for the equal sides. Okay, so this is the required figure. Let's see the last sum, third sum is also the same sum which you have to do now. Okay, construct triangle LMN. So here we'll construct a triangle LMN where two angles are given to us. Those are the base angles and the perimeter is given. So first, what we are going to do, now we have to draw a rough figure. Okay, so after drawing the rough figure, I'm going to construct a triangle. Now it is, perimeter is given to us how much? It is given to us as 11 centimeter. So draw 11 centimeter base PQ. 11 centimeter. Next, angle M is 60 degree and angle N is 80 degree. Okay, so M is 60, so half of 60 is 30. So from P, I will say where is 30, draw a point here and this is 30 degree. Okay, now from point Q, we have to take half of 80, that is 40. Okay, so this is my point L. Next step, we have to draw a perpendicular bisector for LP and LQ. So place the point of the compass at point P, take a distance more than half. Okay, see, draw arc up and arc down. Similarly, from point P, I bisect this arc. Okay, now join the two points by drawing a line segment. So this is a perpendicular segment which has been drawn. Okay, it divides into two equal halves and this is my point M. Similarly, for LQ, we'll draw a perpendicular bisector for LQ. Okay, take a distance more than half, draw arc up and an arc down. From point L, I bisect this arc. Okay, I just drawn it. So now let's draw a line passing through these two points. Okay. So I'm going to draw a line. This is a perpendicular bisector. These two sides are equal. So this is my point N. So now join point L and N. So you get segment LN. Okay. And joined L M. Okay. Now you measure this angle. It should be 60 degree. And if you measure this, it should be 80 degree. So this is your required figure. Show which sides are equal. So this is the required figure. Okay, now for your homework, you have to solve question number 2 and question number 3 from your problem set and also complete this exercise in your notebook. Thank you.